Hello and welcome to this episode of Makerbox Mondays. In this video I'm gonna have a look at IC3D's TPU-70D. So let's have a look after the intro. So this filament is a TPU based, but it's not very flexible. It's like a semi-flexor or something like that. But let's have a look at the label. And here they say the TPU-70D hot head temperature should be 230 to 250, bed temperature up to 80, speed not listed, cooling not listed, and other none. And here they say it's an ultra tough impact resistant filament. The higher durometer TPU is stiffer than the flex TPU you're used to, but it maintains the benefit of toughness. It's a bit more flexible than PETG and should not require any special consideration when printing. And more information at ic3dprinters.com. But let's have a look at the prints. Here I did serialize a lot, and there's some stringing issues, not quite bad though. There are just some, and otherwise the overhangs came out pretty good. And overall, like, it's like a crystal snow white color. It's somewhat like a snowball feeling. It looks pretty good. It's somewhat flexible. You can bend it to some degree, but nothing like a normal TPU. Like they said, it's much stiffer than a normal TPU. But I can twist this around and it won't break so easily. It's, you can see here, it's somewhat flexible, but it's still pretty stiff. But this came out, like I said, pretty good. Some stringing issues. Then did a benchy, and here you can see a little bit of stringing as well. And this one is more stiff. This model is difficult to bend. But it's really tough. You can abuse this quite a bit. It just moves a little bit, but the surface finish is quite good here, like really shiny, you can see in the camera. And here are some cooling issues. I wasn't running with any cooling for this print. But you can see the some gunks coming up here, but otherwise the brand came out pretty nice, just beside the stringing. And I printed the maker coin, and here you can see the snow like texture. It's the texture is somewhat rough, but you can see here on the back side, so like the details in the letters here, you can't really see them. It just runs into a blob. It's difficult to see on camera. I can hardly make out the letters with my own eyes. So this is maybe not good for extreme details, but for, I think, for mechanical parts or some applications, it could be a really good option. It's really tough. I'm trying to break this off. Just it won't allow me to take this off. So layer adhesion is excellent. And then here's Mr. Belly, and here you can see the stringing. It's somewhat stringy, but I can twist him quite a bit. And here I got his leg off with quite a force. That it's really tough filament, and this is just a two parameter print. There's no infill, so that's just the outer layer. See, I'm twisting the arm or leg, sorry. It's quite difficult to break, so it's really tough filament. So this was quite fun filament. It's extremely tough, somewhat flexible, like I say, it's like semi-flex. It's durable. I think this could be used for some mechanical applications that need some dampening or some thing like that. But this will be it for this episode. I thank you for watching, and I will see you in the next one.